Test, 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 audio test, check, check. Test, 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 audio test, check, check. Cool, sounds good, alright, so,
Welcome.
Starting up again, cool. I guess. Sounds,
Picking up where I left off, I guess, on this character. I think I gotta mute my stream. Hopefully it'll stay connected here. I'm working on this character. Spent a little bit of time the other day working on some shoe stuff as I was talking to one of the viewers, and other than that, I'm probably going to have to go back and rework a little bit of that, because I actually didn't save a backup of any of that, so I need to go back and rework the shoe at some point. But for now, I feel like moving on. I've decided I really want to layer this character up correctly, so I'm going to be looking at blocking out or building out more of this shirt. I'll probably just pull from here to get everything in place. And I should probably move the viewers list off in the chat here so I can see everything. Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna kind of come in here and just start blocking out this shirt and maybe cleaning up the vest and playing around with some of the designs on the clothing and adding a few other elements to the character to before I kind of move into more of a cleaning and finalizing process. Hello! Hey! How's it going? Sorry, didn't see you there. I'm gonna be, doing some stuff, I guess. Welcome. How goes? This always resets on me. Oh, jeez. I Alright. Yeah, I was, I don't know why it reset on me while I was in the middle of typing it all out, too, but hopefully that, that'll get it all. Oh, jeez, did it reset again? Is this just my stream, like, coming in and out here? This is gonna be a disaster, isn't it? So that doesn't become an issue. Alright, jeez. Hopefully that'll stick this time. It seems like every time I look up, it's changed on me. So hopefully that won't continue to be the case. Thanks so much for catching that. Hopefully I can remember to keep up with that one. It's definitely an important one. Sleeves. Stretchy sleeves of doom. Excellent. Alright. A little bit of structure here. A little bit of volume there. Yeah, build up the shoulder a little bit. Oh, I gotta get that back face mask on there. These brushes will never work well without that. There we go. Oh, thank you so much for the offer. I could always use... I mean, if it gets busy anyway, I could definitely use the help, so... Cheers. For now, I'm happy to have viewers, though. Welcome, welcome again. As a mod, yeah. Well, gotta start somewhere. I have zero experience streaming. Yeah, I guess he does look a little bit like James Stewart. I haven't really finalized the face details yet, but we'll see how it goes. Might be some good inspiration to pull from, actually. A little bit of reference never hurts. Ugh, I did this the hard way. I originally wasn't going to build the underlayer shirt, but I decided I really wanted to. I always get like that, you know, when I'm sculpting stuff out. You know, I try to think of it practically, and then within a few minutes, all I want to do is flesh out the design more and more. I guess that's, you know, why you end up in doing character, or one of the reasons you can end up doing characters all the time, I guess. Just like the stories behind it, designing it. It's hard not to want to flesh out all the details. Can I hide the pants? No. Tuck all that in. Pretty good for now. Jacket in the vest. Oh shit. Get that vest back. And of course, this is just making me want to organize these subtools a little bit more here. Can I just lose that? There we go. Let's just do that for now. There we go. There's my fast. I'll just nudge that down there for now. Alright. So I kind of want to do this layer. Clean this up a little bit. Do sort of a layer on top of that. That Hey, I'm doing good, Fally. How are you doing today? Working on a vest design at the moment, just sketching out a few different lines and ideas for building out the shape on this vest for this character. Trying to kind of stack some layers and play around with it a little bit. At the moment, I'm kind of using, trying to reuse some of the lines that I used in the jacket. But I'm not sure how well it's going to come through at the moment with the way that I've got it shaped. So I may end up changing that a little bit. But, yeah. That's kind of what I'm up to. Yeah, he's definitely got a bit of that look going to him, the Chicago gangster. Yeah, I definitely kind of have that that sort of. I wouldn't necessarily call him a gangster as a character, but yeah, I can definitely see why that feel would suit this style of design. And I think that actually is sort of appropriate still for how I'm thinking of him. Played by James Stewart, yeah. Oops. I think I want to kind of bring this out a little bit more. Maybe do a few different angle changes or something. Maybe more in like this. Let's get like a bigger brush going here and just pull this in. Or I could like do an asymmetrical thing where I like fold one side over. Maybe it needs to be more simple. Maybe it's more of a. Maybe I should stick with the inspiration in this element of the design. I'm just kind of. Whoops! Symmetry, I want that back. I just kind of want this to taper straight in. And then back out. Maybe that would work better. I think I'm gonna try that out. Sort of the truest to the original style. Area to play around, but I can layer this up, or at least suggest it in the design. Let's get that flattened down a little bit. Yeah, I think that might work better. I'm going to kind of close this up a little higher, though. Alright. So that gives me enough length to read the tie, which is the other thing that I wanted to do. Let's bring that out a little bit more. go. Like that. Yeah. So now, on the vests, maybe I grab the Damien Standard and just throw in some lines. Yeah. These vests have these, like, cuts on them, right? So, gotta block in. Maybe this is where I can use those lines that I wanted to use earlier. I think that's what I'm gonna try. Let's just clean that edge up. I'm gonna dig this in a little bit. I gotta kind of clean this up a little bit first. Alright. Oops. Take that in a little bit. Maybe I'll even move this in a little closer. Tuck this in up towards the neck. Get it more up close to the collar here. That'll give me a little bit more room to play with as well. A little bit more space in the collar. Straighten that line out a little bit. Don't want to lose too much of that space, but there we go. Yeah, that works. Alright. Let's gotta clean that up. There we go. And you. Why not Marvelous? Mostly because I'm using this for a few different purposes. One of the things that I want to do is be able to use this as sort of just a general demo for my students, because I teach, and I wanted to have something that utilizes tools that they still have access to, and we just don't have that at work. I don't really have a lot of experience using Marvelous at the moment, and certainly not that I'm opposed to it. I look forward to learning it and practicing with it a little bit, but unfortunately, this particular piece isn't going to be that piece, which is okay. I need to brush up on my cloth sculpting skills anyway. But normally, I totally would. I totally would use a tool like Marvelous Designer or Marvelous, probably just Marvelous Designer, pretty much. Or at least I generally want to use it for cloth. Wonderful looking tool. Don't have a lot of experience with it, but the work that I see being done with it just, yeah, there's doesn't seem like it makes any sense to not use it these days. Yeah, Vancouver weather is definitely dreary. are you familiar with the region, or do you live there as well? Or here as well, I guess I should say. For a minute, it's just getting in the way, isn't it? Gonna see the shape that he's getting here. I think the sleeve space is a little too big here. This will give me even more room to play with. It's a bit better. This one crashed. This area. Well, welcome to Vancouver, I'm jealous of your weather in Miami. Well, unless it's terrible, I haven't actually checked the weather, but it's generally sunny, right? generally with Marvelous Designer, it just seems like going in and sculpting it out, or sorry, simulating it out just makes so much sense for those folds. Raining today in Miami. Oh, jeez. It's, I guess, not too unlike here, although I imagine a fair bit warmer than. If I bring this line out, then I can kind of taper it more as it comes in. Bring that back out down here. I want to kind of use this to pull some more shape around in this character. There we go. I don't like how it's kind of fitting over the shoulders now, actually. It's too far out. My hotkey's all funky. That's better. There we go. Now I can keep doing what I was doing. Alright, back to work. Back area a little bit better. I want to really get a nice sort of sharp taper going in the waist area, or sort of just above the hips, I guess, kind of right in here. And I gotta tweak this shape around a little bit for that. Hopefully, as long as I'm just tucking the outer shirt layer in, I can fit everything to the body anatomy still. Although I'm probably going to have to tweak that as well. It's still pretty rough also. Let's go with that for now. Slim that down a bit. Cool. Good. Alright. Cool. Okay, so where was I? Always with the sidetracking here. Alright. Back to it. Slice some lines. Alright, so I had that jacket line. I think I could probably recreate something like that here. Just sort of as a seam, right? Kinda. Drop in maybe a collar. Maybe I want to keep it simpler. Do something out. Out, down. Back in. Down. Yeah. I think that'll work, and then probably a cut. Maybe a straight cut right through here. You can do it like angled and then down. Like a larger version of that same shape. Yeah. That'll help separate out the back piece. The back panel will maybe start off of here, I think. It's going to be a good spot. Build up a little bit of this. And just clean up a little bit of this edging while I'm here. little Kelly buildup, and then smooth it out a little and crash it back through. There we go. Alright. Gotta separate that a little bit. Where do I want this back piece to go? This is sort of a separate piece. Separate layer, right? So it can kind of sit a little differently as well. Maybe it runs off straight and then cuts across. That could be interesting. Again, kind of mirroring that, the angles of the jacket. It's not mirroring her. Here. Normally it would be, I guess, like a silk, but I just want to kind of block this in more as like a cloth. Or not like a cloth, I guess. Maybe like a bit of armor or something. Just to break up these shapes. This is what happens when you sit at work all day thinking about just different stupid design ideas. What if the back of the vest was armored? Yeah. So maybe, what would be good? Something. Do like a spinal type thing. Maybe mix a little cloth in some spots. Kind of do like softer regions, kind of out here maybe. Like a harder spinal section. Hey. Hello, how's everybody doing out there? For now. We do like a I don't want to shape this. Maybe I'll just keep the lines going. I'll probably go back and sort that out. Lots of Vancouver folks popping in. Hey. By lots, I mean two, but you know, that's lots. Just started this. I'm always excited. How about that rain, eh? That is, like, not the same size at all. Oh, yeah. Fix that up a little bit, but I'll just sketch it all in for now. I'm getting sidetracked here. I'm trying to design all this stuff still. I'm just blocking. What am I doing? Sketch this in for now. Do-do-do. A little volume. How is that going to kind of connect out? Maybe, second layer that kind of it's gonna have to be some sort of space for that to sit into. I'm just playing around with different ideas for what I want to do with the back, but I'm kind of thinking sort of some sort of rather unusual armor plate layering or something that sits off of these spinal bits. Maybe they're layered in some way. And just sort of protects his back He doesn't trust people. Sort of maybe a lighter armor layered into the front piece, the layer that comes up through the front as well. But it's meant to be more subtle and blend in with the style of the vest. Yes, from gangster to steampunk alien, yeah. He's a character from a story concept that I'm using this time to kind of rough out and build up. Sort of a private investigator character, but he works for a large insurance protection agency, and I guess basically aids in a variety of different ways. So it's meant to take place in sort of a not so distant future, but he's fairly styling. He makes a decent amount of cash, and he has a distinct sort of taste for certain styles, and he likes the sort of traditional style of clothing and things like that. Or, well, I guess not traditional, but this sort of style of clothing, I guess. And that's why he kind of finds and has made pieces that are like this. So it's sort of more modern takes on these sort of older styles. Well, the enforcer with fashionably deadly weapons, yeah. I don't know about weapons so far. I've only kind of built up a little holster for a small, like 9mm concealed firearm, but I might consider something a little bit bigger on him at some point. I'm not sure. For now, a little bit of armor. I think he prefers more to keep himself protected than to dispatch any additional damage on his own, I guess. Yeah, actually, I caught a little bit of Dan's stream this morning when he was doing the Dead Mouse. It was looking pretty frickin' sweet. I wasn't able to stay long duty called at work, but I got to check it out in the morning. Oh, Jesus, it's a terrible size for that. Maybe I can break this up into some smaller shapes here. Into something a little bit more intricate as it scales down. Maybe I'll switch this shape over. Let's move that out a little bit. Oh man, yeah, doing likenesses, it always seems to take forever, because, I mean, it's so easy to spot the mistakes, and it can be such a task to fix them. But I do a few classes doing likenesses, so I kind of do the process once every couple months. And every time, you know, it can even be really hit and miss, like what'll work out and what won't. I find it's especially tricky to even get the right shape sometimes, and other times you just like hit it. You just get that everything starts to fall into place in a couple hours, and sometimes it can take like a couple of weeks of reiteration and staring at it. Deadmau5 ended up coming on the stream with me later in this morning and chatting with me about the head. Oh, wow. Jeez. That must have been pretty awesome. Nice. I'll have to take a look at some of that archive and catch that bit. Do you archive it anywhere else? Nice. I don't know if I'd say I'm a ZBrush master, but I certainly have to use it a lot. That's, I don't know why I'm overlapping that. I don't really like that. Whatever. Actually, no, that might work. Yeah, I noticed. I think I heard you say something when you were streaming about having gotten those photos directly from him, so that must have been... I guess that's a cool relationship to have there. Very neat. This is getting pretty even. Yeah, I teach at a top art school. I'm the least qualified on the staff in terms of industry experience, but I suppose the work itself does give me a lot of time to get in the practice that I need to kind of keep my skills up, which is nice. So thank you. I'm glad you think that that I've got a decent skill set here. I hope that I can definitely take this to a complete state as I go through the whole process. Hopefully that'll give folks a lot to enjoy and chew on as I go through this process. Lots to do. Obviously, and I unfortunately only get a short amount of time during the week usually to do this sort of stuff, so hopefully I'll be able to chew through it quickly enough, but I find this design stage to be pretty slow, mostly because it's so easy to want to change things another way. I don't really have anything particular enough in mind to make it a smooth process, but I guess I'll see how far I end up taking this. Hopefully I can finish it up for you guys and have something cool to take into some other tools as well. I really want to kind of use this as sort of a springboard to play around with tools like Mari a little bit more. Since we just got that at work or at the school I teach at, I want to kind of brush up on it and really try some of that stuff out and get a little bit more more experience in the texture painting side of things as well, which I think is something that, you know, I've had a lot of experience kind of working with students from their end, kind of tweaking their work, but I find unlike sculpting, I really have to kind of sit down and kind of go through a whole process to really understand it a little bit more, so you know, I don't quite get the experience doing texturing in my classes that I do and do with ZBrush. So I want to kind of brush up a lot more on that stuff. So what that should do. Identify these things a little bit here. Look. Think you might have a kinky side, looks a bit corsety. You know what? It's funny that you mentioned that, because I've done several, well, I've played with different designs of several characters, and they tend to end up with corsets. I don't know why. I like sort of the modern slim fit sort of trends in style, and I guess perhaps that's just me wishing that I could fit into smaller clothes, but, you know, wishful thinking, but perhaps it is. Perhaps it is a bit more of a kinky side, but I guess really it's, I just find the, I guess maybe it's just my the time that I study anatomy and just kind of looking at proportions and, you know, lots of different, inspirations as well, that just kind of, you know, it's just sort of the that taper, that line that it kind of creates. I don't know, it's a look. But yeah, I was doing a Magneto sculpt a while back. I should probably dig it up and finish that too one day. Maybe I'll go back to some of my unfinished pieces soon and do a little bit of work on those as well. Maybe if I get really tired of poking away at this thing for too long. But I definitely want to finish this, so maybe not. But the Magneto character that I had designed was sort of, was looking at a lot of Mass Effect meets Assassin's Creed type stuff. Really kind of dealing with that, and I ended up giving him sort of a corsetti type thing as well. I did sort of a tiefling character at one point. And by did, I mean I roughly sculpted and designed for a class. A lot of this stuff I do just in demos, you know, so I get, you know, a few hours here and there to kind of work on it every week, and then hope that I get decent enough along for the students that they can run with what they learn in that time, and you know, generally they get a pretty good amount out of it. But it was he ended up, as it was originally sort of an anatomy study, and that ended up being being another character that ended up with a corset. do I have an art station? Yeah, I do. No, I don't. I look at art station a lot. I've checked out a lot of other people's work on art station, but I haven't actually set up any of my own stuff. It's been so long since I've posted anything anywhere, really. I think I just kind of forgot that it was even possible, and maybe part of it's just that I don't enjoy, the process of stopping to take photos and document my piece or the process in some way. And the other part is that I never ever get to finish anything. It's kind of either a bad habit or just the nature of the way that work kind of functions for me. But you know, when you spend a day troubleshooting with students, sometimes it can be difficult to want to sit down and do work of your own all of a sudden. So, you know, I'm hopefully using this as a way to kind of segue into something like that, though. So who knows, maybe I'll get one soon. It does seem like it's the sort of thing, yeah, all the kids are doing. I'm certainly no young whippersnapper, but I think I can figure out technologies well enough, so hopefully it's something that I can wrap my head around and try out. I upload a lot of my time lapses to Vimeo, and I think the Vimeo link's down in the section below somewhere, buried near the bottom probably. And I try to post up anything that, usually a lot of the sculpts that I get through in class. It's a lot of the likeness sculpts that I do, and it's, you know, the two classes that I get to block them out in. So it's usually, you know, a few hours of just rough work. So some of them turn out better than others, but yeah. I even have one. I'm really hoping that this whole Twitch thing will help kind of push me to finish off one of these pieces a little bit more. It's gonna make me a little sad to move out of ZBrush, but I know I'll have to do that to take this to the level that I want. But it'll be nice to have even just the archive sort of document of the process and everything as well, because you know, it's just nice to share that with my students as well. I'll leave that blocked in like that for now. Do I have a pinch somewhere in here? I'm gonna render in Maya. I generally do that because mainly because that's what I'm most experienced with. All of our students do their final stuff in Maya. You know, most of that training is for visual effects and film type work, so we don't do anything really in real time with the 3D students. So most of my experience is with Mental Ray, but I'd love to try to get this into Arnold as well. I'm on the been on the beta list for a while, and I mean, they're obviously they've released their final product now, but I haven't had the chance to really bring anything final into that, so that might be something that I'd try to do as well. Alright, have a good night, Dan. Thanks for stopping by. PBR. The PBR looks really interesting to me. It's something that I really I want to learn because I'm starting to teach, or I'm going to be teaching next term, design students ZBrush, so I want to kind of use the BPR for them instead of having them take their work into Maya or something like that, because that's not going to be something design students are really going to need. So hopefully I can introduce some of these tools to them and then learn a little bit about the PBR render and do some more of that. I really like the idea of some of these faster little renderers that are becoming sort of a more standard part of these tool sets. So I don't have access to KeyShot, but that would be an interesting one to poke around with as well. But I really like the idea of working you know, from a more production-centric sort of side, I do like the experience that I get kind of just sticking with sort of the industry stuff as well. I find there's an interesting sort of process to that I find sort of gives me lots of flexibility. I can kind of take things to another level and get a lot out of it. So I'm not quite willing to completely ditch those things yet, maybe. I don't know. But I'm curious to see where some of these other renderers go to. Sorry, I'm just kind of rambling. For the key shot, you find it easy to get hard surface renders? Yeah. It seems that it's just kind of... A lot of those really fast GPU-style renders seem to do well with that sort of stuff, right? The shiny, glossy metals and things like that, right? They just tear through that stuff and make it look good. I think like some of the other, I can't even think of the names of them off the top of my head, but they all seem to do really well with that stuff. It makes me so sad that most of the work that I do is in Mental Ray, although they're getting a little better. I don't hate them as, I don't hate working in it as, quite as much as I used to. Yeah, it would be interesting to try out the PBR at some point and get into that. Alright, I need to do a little bit more than stare at this. Let's block in a little bit of buttons and kind of... Ooh, I gotta do the seam down the middle. What am I doing here? Let's get that carved in. That's a shirt that's going to have a seam here. There we go. Let's give that a little bit more definition there. Oh, is it CPU based? I didn't realize that. Huh. Wow, wow. Fast renderers then, damn. Oh, this is gonna overlap. What am I talking? What am I doing here? What are you doing? Pay attention. It has to overlap, of course. That's how shirts work. X. Just carve that in. It's just gonna go like that. Back across. Slows down with blurry, translucent, and subsurface. Yeah, a lot of renderers do. I mean, there's very few that I've run into that don't struggle with that sort of stuff. Even RenderMan was slower with it, and I kind of both loved and hated the RenderMan skin. Buttons. close enough for now. Won't be enough to give it the idea. Alright. There's going to be, of course, buttons on the door. This needs a bit of an extension. Maybe there's like a component here that wraps around. It just kind of overlaps into the front a little bit here. Maybe like a part of the piece that holds it in or something. It wraps around there, almost like a holster or something. Right? This little thick trim. Not sure how I like that. It could work if I kind of thicken this up a little bit, maybe. Do just like a hint of armor piece here or something, or another layer. Sick of looking at it with that skin shade on there. It's just going to be a bit more rigid than the rest of the surrounding areas. Sketch in just some rough folds. Let's do just a standard brush. Doing these symmetrically, so I'm gonna just keep it simple until I kind of get that. Shapes that I'm on. I'll flow into that a bit. I don't really like doing the cloth too much, really. What does a degree cost at VFS, more or less? I'm not entirely sure that you get a degree. I guess there's a diploma, and there might be a degree. I'm not quite sure how that works right now. But yeah, regardless, the course, I believe, is, I'm not even sure, I want to say like 30 or 40,000, maybe 50. Especially if you're from outside of Canada.
So how have you been?
soften this up a lot. This is sort of a really soft sort of material. There's some wrinkles all through here. All that down later. I could actually still take this into Marvelous Designer, I suppose, couldn't I? I could kind of use this just as a template for the design and stuff. I suppose it might be something to try out at some point, too. But for now, the design. I think I'm just going to do that. Weird. I usually mumble in my class, and now I know everyone who's. Well, I suppose I'm explaining, not mumbling to some extent. But it is sort of more of a habit than anything else, I guess. But I'm hoping that it's at least interesting. If you rather I shut up and so you can hear the music. Pain. Let's get these, let's get this all kind of cleaned up a little bit more here. Oh, missing my hotkeys. Thanks, maybe I should,